enemy strength is increasing. Latest units observed are capable of deploying regenerating shields. Enemy strength is growing at a pace that closely matches Carpathia deployment strength. Possible implications. 1. Enemy strength is derived from, or connected to, Carpathia's strength via some unknown mechanism. Or 2. Enemy is much stronger and is purposefully weakening itself during early engagements to test us. Carpathia stationed over colony Kallak now. We'll report more information as it is gathered.
Sensors detect a heavily shielded ship approaching the colony. Shields can be destroyed, but they will regenerate quickly. The pulse cannon isn't a powerful tower, but it ignores shields and may be a more effective way to deal with these ships. We've rescued more colonists from Kallak. Good news, but almost too good. It's obviously not safe leaving the colonists' planet side, but the Carpathia was never intended to be a transport. We're running out of room, and fast. I contacted Darius Erdman himself through the wormhole relay and requested he send more transports. Darius refused. He said our priority is to prevent human technology or information falling into alien hands, including the location of Earth. So we won't be getting any transports until the whole planet is secured. We'll have to come up with another solution. Light mortar is a cheap, long-range tower and can splash groups of frigates. We should use it here and take advantage of the range to cover multiple paths at once.
Transmitters are online. We can use them to overcharge turrets and significantly increase their rate of fire.
We've rescued more
Of these enemy vessels continues to amaze me. This mobile nullifier can block any orbital abilities from being cast around it.
Mm-hmm.
We rescued more colonists. The light mortar is a cheap, long-range tower and can splash groups of frigates. We should use it here and take advantage of the range to cover multiple paths at once.
Transmitters are online. We can use them to overcharge turrets and significantly increase their rate of fire. Of these enemy vessels continues to amaze me. This mobile nullifier can block any orbital abilities from being cast around it.
Thank you.
After the last battle, Husk ordered us to secure the colony rule on a more permanent basis. Rescued colonists will be transported there now. It's a risk. If the enemy attacks in force, the Carpathia might be too far away to help. But we don't seem to have any choice. We don't know what to expect at Nahant, aside from more of the enemy. That seems more or less inevitable at this point.
The colonists have attached demolitions to energy cells as makeshift weapons. If we click on the energy cell, it will explode and damage any nearby enemies.
Detecting a new class of frigate incoming. They're equipped with shields and will be resistant to most attacks. They'll be vulnerable to Nova Towers, which do heavy shield damage in an area of effect.
We've debriefed the colonists rescued at Nahant. Combined with some of the other stories we've heard, one thing seems clear. The enemy is purposefully leaving some colonists alive. At this colony and others, the enemy was more than capable of overwhelming the survivors, but they stopped just short. My question is, why? For the bizarre tactics they use, there's obvious intelligence at work behind the enemy's actions. So, why have they done this? We've debriefed the...
Aircraft detected on long-range scanners. They will ignore the terrain. You can use the scan mode with the control key to see their incoming flight path.
Aircraft inbound. They can fly over these mountains and attack our colony directly. We should build some Icarus SAMs and blast them out of the sky.